In this video, my friend Catherine and I are going to talk a little bit about how to see or know if a Chinese guy likes you or not.
Good question.
What's up? Welcome to another video from Lingling. Today I'm here together with my friend Catherine.
Hi guys.
And this video is again one of our Friday Talks AMWF advice videos where we are going to ask your questions about dating interculturally, I guess, so like AMWF. And AMWF is Asian male, white female. If you haven't seen any of the other videos, check it out. We got a playlist, AMWF advice.
Yay.
Yay. If you have any questions about AMWF relationships or dating, you can send me an email on info@lenaaround.com and we will try our best to answer your question.
So Lingling, what's today's question?
Well, today's question is, I'll tell you, we got an email from one of you guys. Hi Lena, I just started watching your recent AMWF videos. I haven't gotten very far, so I'm sorry if you already answered this question. We did not answer this question yet, so. But I was just curious about how Chinese guys act when they have a girl they like. There's this one guy I like, but it's impossible to tell if he likes me too or likes someone else. He moved here, Canada, from China, and I'm so confused. Please help me.
We're here to help. Don't worry. We got your back.
We got your back. But this one is a tricky one. Before we get started, we should probably just say that everyone is different and we don't know very much about this Chinese guy apart from him not showing if he likes you or not. But we are going to talk a little bit about this anyways and see if we can advise a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So how to tell if a Chinese guy is into you or not?
Yeah.
What are your experiences? But maybe what are the differences between, okay, you know, a Western guy who's into you and into dating you and a Chinese guy?
Okay, so we're going to be a little stereotypical here and it's according to our own experience. But what I have seen and experienced is that the Western guy, if he is interested in talking more to you, he's gonna come and be like, hey, what's up? How are you doing? You know, and like, where are you going? Are you, or like, if you're in a bar, you know, he's being flirty. That's
yeah,
what
he's hitting on you.
He's
maybe
hitting on you.
Asking for your phone number and yeah.
Being straightforward. I think the guys I've met abroad or in Denmark, they've been very straightforward. If they want to talk to me, they come and talk to me, and then at some point stuff happens.
Mm-hmm. If they like you, you know it.
You
pretty,
know.
Pretty fast.
You get a feeling. That's what I feel. Yeah, you get a feeling. But on the other hand, when it comes to Chinese guys, that's another story. I was actually, when I read this question a few days ago, I was actually thinking to myself, the guys that I've been dating in China, like Chinese guys, I have been the one making the first move, actually.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Like, I've had a feeling he might be interested, but he would only be a friend. Like, you know, we got each other's WeChat and we talk a little bit back and forth. And then at some point I'm like, do you want to go for dinner? And he's like, yes, of course, you know, and then stuff happens from there. So what me and Kat were talking about just before is that you probably have to take the first step. You have to, yeah, make the first move.
Yeah.
And now we don't know if you're also very shy or insecure, you know, if this guy doesn't like me, it's gonna be awkward, blah, blah, blah. But we were talking about this as well. And one thing you can do is just, you don't have to invite him for like this big dinner party, you know, or anything. You can just make a little move. The winner, the winner of the winner for hitting on a Chinese guy is to ask him to be your language partner. The one time I had, the only time I had a male Chinese language partner, we actually started dating. I don't think we ever learned any Chinese from each other. Like, we never had that, like, let's sit down in the library and talk, learn stuff.
Uh-oh, this is Why Am I Coming. We'll be back. I think anyways, language partner or whatever, try to spend more time with him to get to know him more.
Yeah.
And then with time, you will get a feeling if he likes you or not.
Yeah.
So with Chinese guys, usually if they want to spend time with you, this is a good sign. If he wants to be your friend, probably also means that he wants to date you.
That's true. We talked a little bit about this. So that's already kind of a move for him, even though it's very normal for us just to be like, do you want to be my friend? Or like, we don't even ask that question, you know? We just like add each other's WeChat if you're in China, and then you kind of just take it from there and you have a random friend. But I think if a Chinese guy is interested, he might do that as the first thing, and then he might text you. But again, shy, if he's shy, like I usually date guys that's quite shy, and what I experience is again that I have to make the first move, and then they will text you back.
I think texting is a very, very good indicator for you to see if he likes you or not. Is he sending you text messages? You know, it could be about anything. Does he want to talk to you? Is he commenting on your pictures? Is he liking your pictures?
That's a good one, liking pictures. Yes, that's true. That's a very good one.
Or does he ask you, you know, if you want to hang out, even if with a group of friends? You know, if he wants to do stuff with you around, it means that he's probably into you.
Yeah. And you know, just take it very slowly. Like we were again also talking about this before, that there is just the dating culture here is different.
Chinese boys don't flirt.
No,
they haven't learned it.
And no, that's actually true. Yeah, like it's interesting because I always hear the Chinese girls are like, oh, the guy has to come after me, like I'm not making any move. But if I look at my dating experience here, then it has been the opposite every time. But then afterwards, like one guy, it took him two years to tell me that he liked me.
This is very normal.
Yeah, he was just a friend, you know, and he did not tell me before I kissed him. You have to make the first move if you want something to happen or if you want to know if he's interested.
When I and my boyfriend, when we got together, we have been friends for almost a year. I never thought that he would be interested in more than just a friendship.
Yeah.
Sometimes I got a feeling, you know, because he was texting a lot. We were talking all the time. And
so in retrospect, my boyfriend showed me in a lot of ways that he was actually interested in more than a friendship, but I just didn't realize it. And in the end, after almost a year, I felt now I have to make the first move.
You see, 1 year and no move. So you really, if you want to make sure that you get this guy, then I would also suggest you to make a move.
Get to know him, and then you will also find out if he likes to spend time with you.
Yeah.
That's a good sign, and you can take it as a signal to, you know, make the first move.
Yeah. And I also think we have to mention that very often, I think it's very often portrayed in the media as if white girls or Caucasian girls just don't like Asian guys. So you also have to kind of like try to think about it from his perspective and remember that it might make him even more insecure or unsure if you would even be interested in him as a boyfriend. So really, I think our advice from here is just to make the first move. Whatever kind of move you want to do, but just do, you know, something to show him that that you might like him a little bit more than a friend, as a friend.
We hope that helped a little bit, our advice. It's kind of difficult because we don't know your situation that well.
Yeah.
But keep us posted on how it goes.
Please do. Send me an email again about how it went, or, you know, comment below or whatever you feel like. We really would like to know. I'm very curious. So yeah, I hope that this was useful. And remember, if you have any questions about AMWF relationships and dating, you can send me an email on info@lenaaround.com. We would love to answer your questions. So yeah, remember to give us a thumbs up, subscribe for more videos on Lena Around here, and follow social media, Instagram, and Facebook, and Patreon if you feel like it. We'll see you again very, very soon. Lena and Katrin is out. See ya, and 再见.
Bye bye.
Bye.